Hey guys, welcome back to Restore It. In this episode, we're going to restore the heater and aircon unit, something I had no experience with before I started. As the list of parts to restore gets smaller and we get closer to reassembling everything, I'm going to be working on more and more parts like this. It's not something you'd usually have out of the car, and I think these gaskets are original and have seen much better days. All of the vents are manually opened and closed by cable. I'm going to leave this fascia for the dashboard episode. I'll address things like these stickers then. Does anybody know where I can get these stickers from? This is what we're going to be focusing on in this episode. Let's dismantle it. The resistor that's currently missing and gets very hot must have contacted this plastic cover and melted a hole in it. This poor thing has seen better days as well. All of the pieces involving the cables are color-coded. I guess this makes it easier at the factory to know which cable goes where. This wiring loom is questionable at best. I think someone has been here before. That someone probably not being a certified BMW mechanic. Only the adhesive of this gasket was left, so I scraped it off with a chisel. I just want to take a second away from the restoration to remind you guys to stay safe out there, especially at the moment. And you know where else you need to stay safe? Here on the internet. Which is why today's episode is sponsored by Surfshark. Surfshark is a virtual private network, or VPN, that helps protect your private information online. Surfshark VPN has a bunch of unique benefits, including protecting your passwords, private messages, photos, and allowing you to bypass annoying internet censorship and country restrictions. That comes in super handy being a British guy living in Spain. Everything I do is through Surfshark, so it's like I'm still in the UK, just without the bad weather. Personally, I really like that Surfshark is simple and easy to use, but also doesn't slow down my internet, which is something I've experienced using other VPNs in the past. I also like that it allows me to access blocked websites, online content and applications like 15 different Netflix libraries. Surfshark can be used on as many devices as you like, so you can share it with your friends and family, which is also something other VPNs don't offer. Use code RESTORE IT to get a whopping 83% off and an additional extra month for free. Surfshark also offers a 30-day money-back guarantee, so there's no risk when you try it out. Click the link in the description box and get yourself that good VPN today. I really didn't know what I was going to find opening this thing up. It was quite tense prying these parts out whilst trying not to snap any of the brittle plastic. A lengthy process to replace them, especially at the moment. All of these small foam gaskets were also completely gone. With those side ports off, I could then remove the cables. I lost a few of these clips, and some for the cables, which is very unlike me. They're all on order, but will probably take a few months to get here. Now this part really confused me. I think someone has been in here, changed the radiator for possibly the wrong one, and now the cover won't fit properly. Also, the use of white sealant, is that normal? I don't think so, but I don't know. This radiator did have writing on it, so it's definitely not original. I had to drill these rivets out to remove the metal plates, and then separate the two main pieces to get to the last vent and connector. And that's everything finally apart. It was then time to remove all of the old gasket material and wash off 30 years of dirt. I end up completely dismantling this. It had 6 foam gaskets on it in total. When I did have the resistor fitted, everything worked as it should, so I'm going to reuse this motor and swap it out if and when it dies. For now, I'll clean it and inspect the brushes to make sure they're good to go. With all of the plastic parts clean and dry, I gave them 2 coats of plastic trim paint. I decided to buy a 3D printer pen to see if it would be good at fixing ABS parts. According to the diagrams, this part is not meant to be cut like this. This part I definitely needed. I used the soldering iron to smooth out the edges before adding new material with the 3D pen. I then finally blended it all together with the soldering iron once again. I took a chance on repairing this part to see if I could make it fit as a whole piece, and partly to see how well it would turn out. With a bit of bumper soft filler, they actually turned out alright. I then fully dismantled the front piece and removed all of the old foam. So after cleaning, this is what the plastic pieces look like, quite faded and old looking. And this is what they look like after painting, almost as good as new. Moving on to the radiator, it worked as it should. I just wanted to clean it and remove any imperfections in the fins. The same went for the heater core, which I then dismantled to get at the pipes and the bolts holding them on. With the paint fully dry, I could then add the new foam to the vents. I wasn't sure how much I was going to need, or when it was going to arrive due to the current situation, so I ordered some from several places thinking it was all going to arrive at different times, but all arrived on the same day, which turned out to be a good thing because I used way more than I originally thought I needed. This was quite a lengthy task, each one had to be measured and cut to fit perfectly so everything moved smoothly. Going back to this nightmare of a loom, what I'm going to do is clean it up, resolder any bad connections, rewrap it and leave it like that ready to be reinstalled. When it comes to installing it in the car and attaching it to the main loom, we'll quickly find out what's missing and what goes where. These two aluminium pipes were cleaned, but were so pitted, they will be replaced when the new ones turn up. These cables also needed cleaning up on the wire wheel. The rivets in this bar needed drilling out before I could zinc plate it. It also needed blasting along with the rest of the small parts. The sieve is a great way to blast a load of small parts quickly. Once blasted, I polish them up on the wire wheel. All ready for zinc plating. These were then left to dry for 2 days. One thing, or two things, I forgot to remove were these two top vents. It must have taken me 20 minutes to get them out. They were super tight and a bit of a nightmare. Once out, new foam was then added to both. One thing that was bugging me was the dullness of this red connector, so I gave it a coat of red paint. This gasket looks so sad compared to this new one. There's not much left of this one, but this is what it should look like. Much better. With all of the excess foam I had, I thought why not redo the radiators whilst they're out. As for the really sticky thick insulation stuff, I'm also waiting for that in the post. And that's everything that needs doing done. Time to reassemble it. I'm going to keep quiet until it's all back together again. It's pretty much the opposite of a disassembly, just with what feels like brand new parts. and there we have it, all back together again. Now I'm missing a few things here and there, like clips and the correct resistor, possibly the correct cover for the radiator, or worse yet, the radiator itself. But I'll do some research, and once the parts arrive, I'll update you on my Instagram. I don't know what happened to me on this one, but I also lost one of the big straps that holds on the motor cover. I had to make one out of metal for the time being, whilst I also wait for that to arrive. A bit of a missing part nightmare with this one, but I hope you enjoyed it. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time for a 1M Coupe video. Stay safe.